Hello, this is Craig Mertens, President of Digital Art Solutions. Had a client that had a request on how to do a knockout design with a block letter alphabet. So I'm gonna show you the whole process here. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna work inside of CorelDRAW X7. I'm running our Smart Designer Pro software as well as our Rhinestone Designer software. Just gonna go over here and grab my text tool. I'm gonna left click to create an insertion point, and I'm gonna type in a capital A. I'm gonna select that A. I'm going to go over here to the property bar. I'm going to make sure that lock ratio is selected, and I'm going to type in a value of 6 for height, and I'm going to hit P to center that on my work page. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to choose a new font. You want to use a blocky font. Some of the fonts that work really well for this, like our DAS Sports Block or our DAS Game Day font, are great for doing this. So there's my text. I'm going to make it a different color so it kind of stands out. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to place a contour line around the perimeter of the text. So I'm just going to click on the text. I'm going to go over to my Rhinestone Designer Docker. I'm going to click on Create Contour. I'm going to click on To Outside. I'm going to put a value of 1. I want to do a single contour. And then I want to use an offset value of 0.125. I'm also going to make sure that I have the option for contour selected. So I'm going to click on Apply. There's my contour line. The next thing I need to do is I need to select my clip art image. I want to be very careful about that. I want to use an image that has big, wide lines. It'll be easy to cut and weed. I want to use something that's got a pretty good sized repeat pattern so you can really see that it's a soccer ball. So I'm going to grab my clip art browser. Just click on Clip Art Browser in Smart Designer Pro. We're going to load the clip art browser. And the clip art I'm going to select is from our new PowerPack 3, which is our volume of artwork for doing fundraising kits for vinyl decals. And so I'm gonna go ahead and increase my thumbnail size here. You have sales flyer layouts here and all the popular 15 popular sports. We've got order forms, we've got a cover letter template, concepts for creating your own catalog pages, application instructions, you can include that with your decals. And there's about 360 design templates, but what I'm interested in is the clip art. So I'm gonna go to the clip art, and we have a whole library of vinyl ready, easy to cut, easy to weed clip art. And the image that I want is this one right here. I'm just going to double click on that image. I'm going to bring it in. Now the thing is, we want to grow this image, make it bigger so it covers the graphic. So I'm holding my shift key down and I'm just dragging it up so it's covering the yellow part of the graphic. And then I can reposition the graphic over the text so to create what's called a stamp. Now here's the important thing, is every letter has to be done by itself because you have to reposition the ball over each individual letter. So you have to do these one at a time. So I'm going to select with my left mouse button the yellow area. I'm going to hold my shift key down and select the black area. And then I'm going to go back to Rhinestone Designer and I'm going to go to Fill Effect. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to check Punch Through and Contour Width 0. I'm just going to punch it straight through. So watch what happens. I'm going to hit Apply. It's going to go through. It's going to punch it through. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete the black layer. Just going to select it and delete it. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this outer layer right here. I'm going to grab that outer layer. I'm going to go back to contour, and I'm just going to hit the contour one more time. So I'm going to contour it. And so we've got two objects sitting on top of each other. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hold my Alt key down because I want to select both these objects. I'm going to hold the Alt key down, and I'm just going to marquee, select, and nick the corner. That's going to select both objects, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up on my property bar, and I'm going to click on the combine function to combine them into one object, and we'll make it that same yellow color. There you go. So at this point, we have our design, everything set up. I'm going to right click to turn that little black outline off, and you can see our little layout there. Let's put it on a dark background so you can kind of see what's going on. So that's our soccer letter right there. So you notice that there's a gap between the ball and the edge of the object. The reason we put that in there with that separation is from a weeding point of view, there's no interior elements. So this letter will weed out in one single pole, and I don't have to go and pick the centers out. Except for this little center in the A here, all of this will weed out in a single pole. So that's the process of creating a knockout alphabet with a soccer ball using Rhinestone Designer, Smart Designer Pro, and CorelDRAW X7. And that concludes this lesson.